Hello guys, this is Chirodip and I'm gonna start a new tutorial series of Spring Framework, and in this part we're gonna learn about the basics of Spring Framework and its uses and why it is actually invented, what is its uses actually. So what is Spring is all about? Spring is mainly popular for dependency injection. We will learn what dependency injection is in this tutorial, and that will form a good impression to Spring. Now, what is dependency injection is? This is sometimes called dependency inversion also, and dependency relationship between two objects. So let's check it out, what is actually going to be happening. Now suppose we are having a drawing application and we are having one circle object, and one method is draw, and another object that is triangle, and its also method is draw. Now we are gonna have an application class that will implement the circle object and as well as the triangle object to draw a shape of triangle and circle. So what is actually going to happen? We can instantiate circle object to a class, it will draw a circle, or we can instantiate a triangle object to a class to it will draw a triangle. So how this gonna be happening? Now the application class will contain like this: triangle my triangle new triangle and my triangle dot draw, or in the circle class you're gonna have circle my circle equals to new my circle and my circle dot draw. So suppose we want a polymorphism for this, and we're gonna implement the polymorphism in this scenario. Now suppose we have introduced one shape interface, so this shape interface is gonna take one method, that is draw, and in the circle class we're gonna override this draw method, or in a triangle class we're gonna override this draw method to specify that we are gonna drawing circle or triangle or any other object shape. Okay, so for this we're gonna rewrite our application class like this, and we're gonna implement that shape interface, and we're gonna write that shape equals to new triangle. I'm going to create an reference of shape, and I'm defining one object of triangle to shape, and we are calling shape.draw to draw a triangle. Like this we can draw a circle also, like shape.draw. Now this is the basics of the interface. To achieve a good polymorphism we have to just modify it. From this we are not achieving a good and hard coding polymorphism. We are hard coding it to achieve a polymorphism, but this is not the perfect way. We can achieve this by rewriting the application class, and we can define that in the application class we can define one public void method, that is myDraw, and that will catch the reference of the shape object, that is from the triangle class we can give the shape to the application class, and the shape.draw method will draw a shape of triangle. And similarly we can give a reference to the circle class, and it will take the reference of circle and it will draw a circle. But again you have to somewhere else in the class you have to define this shape new triangle my triangle dot shape, or shape new circle my draw in the parenthesis shape. So anywhere in the class you have to define, we have to explicitly call it and to define what shape is going to draw actually. The shape could be anything, circle, triangle, anything. If you pass circle, it gonna draw a circle or triangle. It knows whichever object is passed, it will draw according to it. But it does not know which object are going to pass. If you pass that object variable, it will just draw that object, and according to that you will get your output, but you have to explicitly specify for that. So there should be an initialization before or after the method, actually the draw method, and from that we can get the reference. Now our application class has triangle. Suppose we have defined one triangle class, triangle method, and the draw method is in the triangle class, and now we are telling the compiler to draw a triangle. Now in the application class we have defined one public void myDraw method, and it's taking the interface reference shape shape, and shape.draw is calling to that method. Now somewhere else in the class you have to define also a new triangle and myDraw shape. Now what's going to happen? We have to define one class member variable. Now what is this thing actually all about? Now in the drawing class we have to define one drawing class actually, so apart from the application class, and the drawing class content will one protected class that is drawing, and one private variable shape. So this gonna we're gonna create a setter method that is a set shape, and we're gonna refer to that shape reference to draw a shape of a particular object. That may be a triangle, that may be a circle, that may be a triangle, or that may be a hexagon, anything. Now public.shapeshape is catching the reference of the particular object and is setting to that shape. Now we call the draw shape method to draw that particular object. Now in the different class we have to define one the triangle reference, and we are calling that set shape method from that class, and it's called and it's drawing the shape method, and we will be getting triangle as output. But in this scenario we are going to implement that polymorphism, so we have to just ask somebody else, some after the class or object, to add this triangle or circle into this app class object. We step one further actually. This dependency we will take outside of the class, and the class will not know what shape is drawing, plus will have just the shape. We have to define it that what shape you are going to draw, and for that reference that drawing class will take the reference and draw according to that. Now member variable of the type shape will take the reference, and shape will contain that accept any shape object of outside of the drawing class and draw according to that. Now as you can see that in the drawing class we have defined that one protected class drawing, and this is the drawing class, and one different class we have defined the triangle, my triangle, new triangle, and we're creating an object, and drawing.shape is calling that drawing class and supplying that my triangle reference an object to draw a triangle, and drawing.drawShape is calling that draw shape method to draw a triangle. Now we have that shape draw, and it's referring to that triangle draw. Now the thing is, here comes the Spring framework. So we are now giving instruction to compiler to explicitly we are defining the particular object to draw a particular object shape. Now Spring framework comes handy in this scenario. What does it does actually? Now the Spring does, the whole thing of dependency has to be changed actually. We have to change this dependency. We have to just not explicitly call the all the shapes we are want to draw actually. We have to change the dependency actually. And drawing class does not own the relationship. It just hold the shape actually. It just hold the shape, and we are passing the reference of the shape, and according to that it's drawing. but it does not know which shape is drawing. You are injecting triangle class to draw triangle from another class, and you can inject circle or rectangle to draw that particular shape. This is the whole concept of dependency injection. This is something Spring makes very easy. You tell Spring what to inject, and Spring will draw you the shape you asked for dependency injection. You don't have to explicitly define the different class or the different shape class to just call that drawing class method. You will tell Spring what methods or what shape you want to just take output, and Spring will draw the shape for you. From the next tutorial onwards, we are going to implement this whole dependency injection, and we are going to implement the Spring framework. I hope you have liked it, and if you have any questions or doubts, just check my next tutorial. I hope all your doubts will be covered up, and thanks for watching. Have a nice day.